What that means is that combined with the implementation on FPGA, which we described last week and which is covered by the patent, now we can mine in real time using the latest version of the AI Oracle.
Hello, you're watching Proactive. I'm joined by Quantum Blockchain Technologies Chairman and CEO, Francesco Gardin. Francesco, very good to speak with you again. You're out with an update on your Method C AI Oracle, and you've reached a breakthrough because you've done the trial in real time this time.
Indeed. Very good morning to you, Steven. It looks like we talk very often nowadays, but that's good news. Yes, indeed, we spoke about the patent a few days ago, and we are now very pleased and proud to announce that months and months of experiments in improving the oracle generated by the AI model of method C has been moving from past data or the blockchains of the past to the blockchains of today. So basically this final version, well, final, there's never a final, but this latest version of the Oracle is able to basically select inputs to SHA-SHA, and it does this with the current blockchain level. And so it's a blockchain of today or yesterday or a week ago, but now it does it in real time with the current level of blockchain. What that means is that combined with the implementation on FPGA, which we described last week and which is covered by the patent, now we can mine in real time using the latest version of the AI Oracle. Now, let's be very precise. The only way we have to run this in real time is to have it on FPGA. FPGA, they have a limited number of lanes because of the available size of the silicon. But this doesn't mean that the method, when on an ASIC chip, cannot do the same job. So what we're really saying here is that we have a hardware which mines in real time with an advantage of the same hardware without the Oracle. Now, where do we go from here? It's very simple. I mean, we will be in the United States next week, and a very selective invitation only meeting with the top experts of Bitcoin mining, and we'll give an official presentation on our method, and that will be the beginning of our commercial engagement with the obvious players that have developed ASICs, and they can add our IP to their existing ASIC chip so that the ASIC chip can boost their performance.
Francesco, just finally, how much more efficient is your method C? What sort of competitive advantage do you have here?
So the data that we have now, they give us indication around 30%. But please remember, this is an AI algorithm which we train using billions and trillions of inputs of SHA, and we need to retrain it every now and again, because if we don't retrain, the performance may degrade a little bit, and it is not a precise formula. So I cannot say it's 32.5% picks. No, it can vary depending on how the blockchain evolves, but so far we have data around 30%, and they've been quite solid for a long time.
Well, Francesco, I hope you'll keep us updated with progress at those meetings in the United States next week. Thank you very much for speaking with us today.
Thank you so much, Steven.
That's Quantum Blockchain Technologies Chairman and CEO Francesco Gardin.